like a Hellcat. So guys, today our topic is basics to solve FIR window sums. So first basics that you should know is what is FIR. Now FIR means finite impulse response. Okay, now let's take example. Now you can say that example h of n, this is impulse response. If we take, see, there are basically two terms, h of n and h of z. H of n means impulse response. H of z means transfer function. Okay, now h of n is given as 1, 2, 3, 4. While h of n is given as, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Up to infinity. So, which one is finite impulse response out of these two? So this is the finite impulse response because range is specified. Range, it's like from 0 to 1, 2, 3. Range is there. But here it is from 0, let's say greater than 0. You don't know the range, exact range from A to B. So this is not the finite impulse response. Similarly, if I take second example, h of n is, let's say, a raised to n u of n, where n is between 0 to 5. So again, range is specified, so this is finite impulse response. So first basic was to identify what is finite impulse response. So our second basic is how to convert infinite impulse response to finite impulse response. Like I said, that if I say h of n is a raised to n u of n, and if n ranges from 0 to 5, this means it is FIR. But if I say n is greater than 0, there is no specified range. It can be 0 to infinity. So this is IIR. So how to convert IIR into FIR? So this is our question. So basically h of e raised to j omega is given. Okay. Now after that we apply inverse discrete Fourier transform. Applying that will give us h of n. Now this h of n is infinite impulse response because there is no range. Now we will use the window technique to convert this h of n into a finite impulse response. So this is FIR. So you can see from IIR we have gone to FIR by using window. Now what is window? Let's see that. So our third topic is what is window. Now see, we have the impulse train, let's say every amplitude is 1 and it goes from positive side and to negative side. This is FIIR. This is infinite impulse response. You can see there is no range. It's from 0 to plus infinity, 0 to minus infinity. It is everywhere. Now if I take one specified value from it, so, and if I can plot that successfully, like it is from 0, 1, 2, 3, let's say 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is FIR. Okay, so using the window, we can take one portion of h of n, alright, and we can plot it. So you can see h of n is the whole graph. We took one portion from it and we plotted it. So this is the window. You can say like, this is the window, alright, and we have this many signals. If it passes through window, then only this length signals are allowed to come out. So you can see the size. The size were large, but window size is small. So when we pass through, we get this. So window does is taking some portion and remaining portion it cuts. So remaining it cuts. So we have this much, alright, signals from positive infinity to negative infinity. So we used window and we found the required signal. This is the finite signal. Now let's see how many windows are available. So the fourth point is types of window. So basically there are three important windows that we should learn. So the first type is rectangular window. Rectangular window says I am equal to 1 when my range is from 0 to m minus 1 and m minus 1 is the filter order. Quite simple. Now Hamming window and Hanning window, the difference is m and n. Don't get confused when you see Hamming and you when see Hanning. Why? Because both the formulas are different. So what this say is Hamming says I am equal to 0.54 plus 0.46 cos of 2 pi n upon m minus 1, and the range is also from 0 to m minus 1. Whereas Hanning says, let's say HAN, alright, Hanning says m is equal to 0.5 minus 0.5 cos of 2 pi n upon m minus 1, and again the range is same. So you can see that. You can see the values 0.5, 0.46 and the signs. So this is very important. So basically we have three types of window, 1, 2 and 3, and they are used to convert an infinite impulse response to a finite impulse response using window. Alright. After knowing the basics, the very important term that you should know is tips to solve sums. Now why I'm giving this? Because first you should understand what are the types of sums that I will show in my future videos, types of sums. And what happens is basically h of e raised to j omega, alpha and omega c. These three terms are asked in different ways that you should know. Let's say there are 4 to 5 ways. So it is very important that you should know what are the types of sums. Second, you should know how to find IDFT, meaning how to find h of n where h of e raised to j omega is given. So the formula is 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi h of e raised to j omega into e raised to plus j omega n d omega. So using this formula we can find h of n, and after getting IIR we can use window and we can get FIR. So this was it. What are the types of filters? So filter types are low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and the band stop filter. So these four are the types of filters. And the next basic is fourth point. Like I will give you the tricks. And what are the tricks? This is the very important point that I have developed. Like you will know the question. After knowing the question, you will know the answer. So basically after question you solve it and you get the answer, but I will show how to get answer directly from question. So this is the trick that will be provided in the future video. Thanks for watching.
तो फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको मेरी वीडियो पसंद आ रही हो देन डू लाइक दिस वीडियो, शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड सब्सक्राइब टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल. तो मिलते हैं अगली वीडियो में. टिल देन टेक केयर. दिस इज श्रेनिक जैन. पीस आउट.